Slovní Halle Kralovka Arena in Prague. It's the Women's EuroLeague Final Four, and after Friday's semi-finals, today is finals day. First of all, the third and fourth playoff game, and later the 2015 Women's EuroLeague Final. Dinamo Kursk play Fenerbahce in what is sometimes known as the consolation final. Fenerbahce just going through their last couple of minutes of warming up. Arisco said in the obvious, both clubs here obviously wanting to be in the EuroLeague Women's Final. That won't happen. Kursk, well, after enjoying a tremendous rookie campaign, they were very, very disappointed with their performance against Ekaterinburg on Friday. It all went wrong for them in the first period, which they lost 13-26. They made something of a fight back in the third period, but the mountain was just too big. Just going out of your screen there, or possibly just receiving the ball, is the player that everyone was looking for in that semi-final for Kursk. Nkadi Ogumiki. I think she had to admit that Ekaterinburg did a wonderful job defending her, particularly in that first half. She ended the first half scoreless after leading everyone scoring-wise throughout the rest of the campaign. It's often the case that small, seemingly insignificant events turn games. And to me, when she picked up a second foul after, well, just a few minutes, had to go out, in danger of picking up that third, that was really when Ekaterinburg turned the screw. She picked up a very, very early foul, and then that was followed by another one. And really, the job of the man on the screen there, Gundis Vetra, became very, very difficult indeed. And the man on your screen, Vetra, Coach Vetra, has an unwanted record of 4 semi-final defeats at the Final Four. And he had to admit that his team was second best. They just couldn't live with a buoyant Ekaterinburg. Fenerbahce, on the other hand, they stayed very close to USK Prague. But a final period, which they lost by 10 points, really was what hurt them beyond all else. They lost that game 49-62. And, well, you're not going to win too many games at this level if you only score 49 points. Big disappointments, as I've said, for Dinamo Kursk in the full performance of Ogumiki and Tina Charles, the number 31 USA teammate of Ogumiki. She had a disappointing game as well. Okay, she got 14 points and 8 rebounds, but her shooting percentage was not what many people expected.
The third place game between the Dinamo Kursk and Fenerbahce. As far as we traditionally introduce the team, visitor, so Fenerbahce, number 4, Olsay Sakiyev.
I'll leave it to our courtside announcer to introduce the players to you. No doubt they will be deflated, but I'm sure they'll give their all. Third place, not better than 4.
12, 25, 31, head coach of team Fenerbahce is Mr. Jacek Hrinsky and his assistant Emma Hermann.
Jack Winici, the Polish coach, 47 years of age, coach to Fenerbahce.
6, Irina Osipova.
And now here come the Russian side, Dinamo Kursk.
10, Epifany Reigns. 11, Maria Dreshnikova. 12, Amit Jacobson.
Simone Augustus, she had a first half to forget as well in that game against Ekaterinburg. She ended up with 13 points and 8 rebounds, but she only scored 2 points in that first half. Disastrous first half for Kursk. This is the last we'll see at this level, possibly any basketball level, for number 5 for Fenerbahce, Agnieszka Bibryska, known the world over as Biba, 32-year-old Polish player, over 100 Polish caps, and making her last appearance on a basketball court. As ever, three lady officials. I have to say that the officiating has been superb since Friday, and I've no doubt that the German, French referees will give us a good game as well. Izel Alban, Turkish player, playing against a Turkish club. Alban plays for Dinamo Kursk. She had possibly the best game for Kursk. 16 points. Former Galatasaray player. Just 1 3-pointer. She would have liked more. But in a game in which your team loses, okay, they lost by 11 points eventually, but it just seemed as though the margin was going to be a lot bigger than that. Izel Alban, the star player on the day for Dinamo Kursk. Very atmospheric arena here. 2,500 fans. That's the capacity. Don't expect it'll be anywhere near full for the third and fourth player, but I'm sure it will build up during the game. There's an hour break between the third and fourth layup and the final itself. And I'm sure, particularly with this Prague on court against Ekaterinburg, there'll be a lot of local support. It almost goes without saying that the key matchup in this game is between Kadi Ogumiki and Tina Charles. As I've said, they both play for the United States national team. Charles, top scored. Well, not quite top scored, but 14 points for Tina Charles in that semi-final, but only shot 35% from the floor. Someone who doesn't take three-pointers, 35%. From inside the arc, he's not good. Kursk, though, a very, very team-orientated situation. Competition so far, they've averaged 18 assists a game. That is very, very impressive. That, in fact, is 5 more than Fenerbahce. Went wrong for Fenerbahce in that semi-final when they allowed far too many open three-pointers, and in particular Thea Palau, 13 points, but those 13 included 3 from 3 from range, so no doubt they will have stepped up the intensity on their defense in this third and fourth playoff. As well as dishing 18 assists a game, Kursk, they really do look after the ball superbly. That is until that semi-final. Only 11 turnovers a game, it takes some doing. Well, rather weary. Looking Jacka Winichki there, possibly offering a prayer or two. Last minute instructions given by Coach Winichki to Gusel Badali de Merman. She had a good game, actually, de Merman. 6 points and 6 rebounds in that semi final. Almost doubling her efficiency throughout the season. Evandy Prince just walked through as shot there. 7 points and five assists in that semi-final, but just 20% from three-point range, one from five. So here we go, the third and fourth playoff of the 2015 Women's EuroLeague Final Four. It's Dinamo Kursk in white and Fenerbahce in dark blue. Juanita Hollingsworth from Fenerbahce wins the opening tap. Well, a good rebound there, and Hollingsworth couldn't quite convert. Here's Irina Osipova, vastly experienced Russian international. Quiet game for Osipova in that semi-final, just 2 points. And the opening score is delivered by Simone Augustus. 2 points at halftime in the semi-final and 2 points in the first minute of the third and fourth playoff. Well, that's a turnover. Hollingsworth expressionless, but I'm sure she'd be disappointed with not getting two clean hands on that. There's the first score of the game. The assist from Ogumiki, the score from Augustus. Ogumiki again. And Augustus inside and on the pull-up, and it's 4 points to nothing. Resist the temptation of saying what a difference the day makes. And there's Ogumiki with a rebound. Tiffany Prince. Ogumiki. And good chase down by Augustus, but she couldn't hang on to it. Bojovic at the point for Fenerbahce. Vitali into Tina Charles on the turnaround, and another rebound for Ogumiki. There's Epiphany Prince. Augustus. Nice inside pass to, well, Irina Osipova. Shot very high off the glass then, and it bounced off the rim. Hollingsworth there, glares at the official. I think Hollingsworth is expecting a foul then, but really she just fell over. Vidali. And the foul. First foul of the game, Irina Osipova. Tina Charles going to the foul line. Looking at the official to say, I had my hands right up in the air, referee, but well, clearly saw on the replay she didn't. And Tina Charles gets Fenerbahce underway. Tina Charles from the legendary University of Connecticut. And the legendary superstar coach of her college team. Ogumiki. Oh, nice pass. And we've got to give Tim Charles that rebound. She tapped it away from the hoop and it fell into the hands of a teammate. Hollingsworth inside this time. Well, she lost the ball again. I think she was expecting a foul, but there's no contact. Augustus, well, she spotted the switch on defense then, but couldn't convert. Here's Vidali, pulls up on the foul line for the jumper and the rebound, Hollingsworth. Bojovic for three, the first three-pointer of the game, puts Fenerbahce into the lead. Milena Bojovic, just 5 points in that semi-final. She hits from the arc to give her team the lead. Ogumiki inside, strong move. Her first score of the game. I don't think she will ever be lacking in confidence, but strategy now puts Kursk back into the lead. Charles sets a pick, and that's a lovely move inside, came off the screen. And Lamont Zelus gets her scoring moving, number 8 for Fenerbahce. This is good defence from Fenerbahce, after allowing Augustus an easy 2 points or 4 points initially. Shot clock on 3, it's got to go up, and does so. And there's the shot clock buzzer, that's a good hustle, and it is Fenerbahce possession. Great little clash there between Eugenia Belikova, Russian veteran, and Badali. Here's that matchup again. Bojovic. Oh, that's a travel, yeah. She faked one way, but both feet went. And he's standing still. Had one step, not two, Tina. So cagey start here in the third and fourth playoff of the Women's EuroLeague Final Four. The Russian side against the Turkish side. And that's foul against the defense, and it is Fenerbahce's 13 on Nikola Hollingsworth. Not the best start for the Fenerbahce number 13. There it is, she attempted to push the screen out of the way. Augustus hits her 6 point. Wow, what a difference on Friday. Hollingsworth's inside, and eventually the foul is called. Very late call, but the two referees looked at each other and decided that was a blocking foul against Irina Osipova. That's her second foul. Here we go. Yeah, she got there too late. Two fouls, Osipova, she comes out. Coming in for the first time, Jelena Milovanovic, 26-year-old Serb. Juanitra Hollingsworth on the foul line. It's two shots. Not sure how she got that nick on the eyebrow. Don't think it occurred during the semi-final on Friday. Might be wrong about that, but well, that second shot even worse than the first shot. Prince comes off Milovanovic's pick. Augustus, that's an open three, which is rebounded by Ogumiki, and she's fouled. Wow, the defense there guilty of allowing an opponent to get the inside position. 3 points now to Mikadi Ogumiki. Ogumiki from Stanford University and LA Sparks player. It was a great matchup yesterday. Two LA Sparks players against each other, sorry, Friday. Candice Parker and Ogumiki. Sure there'll be a little banter in the locker room when we get back to the WNBA. Well, the loose ball on the floor is picked up by Simone Augustus. Inside to Ogumiki. A no-look pass, just about gets there. Here's Epiphany Prince. Nice pull-up shot, but well wide from Epiphany Prince. She did all the hard work. And the ball may just have slipped out of her hands, actually. Juanitra Hollingsworth, one-time naturalised player with the Turkish national team, and on the floor for the first time tonight anyway, Annette Jakobsen, the legendary Latvian player. Bojovic. 15 Charles, and that's a travel again. Second travel against Charles. Here we go. Here's the travel. Both feet went again. Five turnovers. Ogumiki into the corner. Excellent passing from Dynamo Kursk. Great rebounding as well. Where did Yelena Milovanovic come from? Well, Yasekunichi, the Fenerbahce coach, will be absolutely incandescent, allowing two offensive rebounds in quick succession. As Epiphany Prince comes out. Here's Selva Dali. Well, that will inspire them somewhat. The second three-pointer. Was it given as a two? It was indeed given as a two. Can't be a second three-pointer. He's only on 2 points. Who else got that? Was Jovic. Here's Jakobsen. Nice pass. Oh, no foul there. Good defense this time from Hollingsworth. Bojovic. No three this time, but the rebound chased down. Good hustle from Hollingsworth. Oh, and the pass. That would have been a beautiful bounce pass. And this is a fast break, finished off by Simona Kustis. From one end of the floor to the other. Wonderful fast break from Dynamo Kursk. And that all came from a good defensive situation. A hand in the passing lane. And off went Dynamo Kursk on the break. Ogumiki trailing, and oh, the rebound, another offensive rebound for Dynamo Kursk. If they score now, oh, the rebound, Hollingsworth, to tidy up the rubbish. Now, I think Tina Charles got a little whack on the face there. 2 minutes to go in the first period. Charles, no travel this time, but no score either. Augustus, the rebound. He gets the ball down the floor so quickly. Oh, that's a lovely move from Annette Jakobsen. She used the equipment to protect the shot. Wonderful reverse layup. And that all came from a superb pass down the floor from Simone Augustus. So the biggest lead of the game now. It's a 6-point lead. Look at that instant pass down. Jakobsen inside. And no one's going to block that shot. Dali. Dali really needs to show some leadership now. She's quite capable of doing that. The number seven for Fenerbahce. Well, nothing dropping for Fenerbahce as Siobhan Zalouz fails to hit the jumper. Lucille Alban, distinctive blonde-haired guard for Dynamo Kursk. Here's Augustus. Augustus defended by Zalouz. Augustus pulls up. Not this time, and the rebound, Hollingsworth. Fadali. And this time, Tina Charles is fouled by Milovanovic. Was it indeed a foot violation? No foul. My apologies. It was a mere foot violation. Charles. This time she doesn't fake with both feet. On the turnaround, Tina Charles doesn't get the drop. Zalouz can't get the rebound. Milovanovic strong. Jakobsen, 40 seconds remaining, and the steal, great steal. Now, an easy layup there. And it's Milana Bojovic. Oh, she just picked the pocket of Annette Jakobsen. Simone Augustus, Alban, no way through, good defense, Hollingsworth, Milovanovic for three, Yelena Milovanovic, and coach Jacek Winici looking somewhat concerned there with his team now trailing by seven. 3 seconds and the foul, 3.5 seconds left in the first period, and Dynamo Kursk foul, not yet in the penalty. There's the reach from Jakobsen. 3.5 seconds, first period, that's all that's remaining. Zalus has got to fire up, and that's, well, there was a foul. She got the elbow, she being Simone Augustus, and immediately turns to the official and says, good call, ref.
First
that she does dispute the call. Let's have a look. There's a touch on the elbow, more than a touch, in fact, a bit of a whack. Siobhante Zalus misses the first. There are 0.2 seconds remaining in the first period. Zalus, 7 points yesterday. Sorry, Friday again. And she hits the second. It will be a 6-point margin after one period of play. Dinamo Kursk lead Fenerbahce 18-12. We're watching highlights of the first period of the consolation final, the third and fourth game at the 2015 EuroLeague Women's Final Four. After one period of play, it is Dinamo Kursk leading Fenerbahce 18-12. So almost ready for the start of the second period in the third and fourth playoff here in Prague. Dinamo Kursk will begin this second period, and that's out of bounds, that's sloppy indeed. Annette Jakobsen there, she inbounded the pass and then jumped and received it while still in the air, but feet were last out of bounds. That's a very clumsy turnover. Badali. And the rebound. Strong rebounding from Tiji Kanitez. Neither team boxing out particularly well. And on that occasion, Dinamo Kursk not even bothering to rebound. Here's Badali again, drawing the double team. Zalus inside. Oh, four without reply for Fenerbahce at the beginning of this second period. Alban, Ogamiki, Jakobsen. Oh, that's a lovely play again. Strength inside from Kadi Ogumiki. Bojovic to Charles. And Charles nails the jumper. What's the expression? Paul warned his forearm. She was not going to fake her way to the hoop then. Augustus, Ogumiki being denied. Alban. again. This time, good boxing out from Fenerbahce, and the pass down the floor, and the foul is Alban. Well, she's really ducked to protect herself. I think she thought someone's going to turn the lights out, and Tina Charles is going to land on her. Here we go. Now she knew the pass was coming, and really, the foul was an attempt to protect herself. I think she might have got one in, got a fat lip there as well. So Epiphany Prince back in to replace Alban. Oh, great change of pace and the foul. Well, slow footwork there from Ogwumiki. Coach Minichki applauds a lovely little fake there. First foul, Ogwumiki. And we have a timeout. First timeout of this third and fourth playoff with the scores tied. Dimmer Kurs 20, Fenerbahce 20. Some great basketball here in Prague in the Women's EuroLeague Final Four, and there's going to be even more fabulous basketball in June in Hungary and Romania. It's the Women's EuroBasket 2015. I'll be in Sopron in Hungary for the first stage, and Gyor for the second stage. I just can't wait. Watching highlights of the first period, first half rather. The third and fourth playoff, and some very relaxed play from both teams, and Siobhan Zalus an opportunity to give Fenerbahce the lead. They have trailed by 7 points at one stage. Well, she doesn't get the and one. Epiphany Prince comes off Ogumiki's pick. Fenerbahce in what looked like a zone for a second. And that's good hands from Tina Charles with five on the shot clock. Oh, good reading of it by Tina Charles. That was good defense in two situations from Charles. On court for the first time for Fenerbahce is Tugba Pelazoglu. Didn't score in Friday in that semi-final. Milovanovic. And again, no rebounding from Dinamo Kursk. Here's Vidali. Into Charles again. And this time she scores. And, well, actually she gets a shot away with no travel. And she pulls the foul. Foul Milovanovic. Well, soft shot of the glass, but he's bounced out. Milovanovic takes the break. Irina Osipova back in on two fouls. Well, Fenerbahce take the lead. This is the second, though. It's a one-point lead for Fenerbahce. Epiphany Prince. Ogumiki takes over. Oh, nice pass into Osipova. And she has her shot blocked. And what's more, she touched it last. Good defense there from Fenerbahce. Rather a labouring shot from Osipova. And it was all ball from Tina Charles. Zalus. Oh, lovely little shake and bake from Zalus, but she misses the jumper. The rebound, Charles. And eventually Osipova comes up with a defensive rebound and the foul to stop the break. Justice is on her way to the hoop and she was fouled. And the foul to Glep Bozoglu. Prince inbounds. Here's Jakobsen. Back to Prince. Again the jump shot missed. And again, just one rebound of four. Kursk against four. Charles inside and she's fouled by Jakobsen. Well, after two early turnovers by Tina Charles, she's now causing havoc in that low post. Great ceiling from Tina Charles. Jakobsen has just picked up her second and her team are now in the penalty. Simone Augustus takes a break. Zelus. Osipova nearly got the loose ball there and Ogumiki did get the loose ball. Tried to take it on one hand. That was a lovely outlet pass from Osipova. Ogumiki on the pull-up and doesn't get the drop because Tina Charles gets the rebound. A three-pointer, considerably short, Tucci Canitez. Third and fourth playoffs. Nearly always a good opportunity for coaches to give players who don't normally get much court time some experience. And I expect we'll see a lot of that. Osipova, Ogumiki. Good defense from Fenerbahce. No backdoor there. Here's Jakobsen with three on the shot clock. It's got to go up and does so. And the rebound by Tina Charles. Coach Vetra looking somewhat concerned there. His team have led by seven. Now they trail by one. And the rebound grabbed there by Eugenie Velikova. I'm not sure Osipova wanted that ball in. However, Tina Charles has just been called for foul holding Ogumiki. We have another timeout. There's the foul. And a bit of a wrestling match in that low post. Timeout, Fenerbahce. Watching highlights of the first half in the third and fourth playoff of the 2015 Women's EuroLeague Final Four. And Dinamo Kursk, having led by seven, now trail by one against Fenerbahce. Out of bounds, Kursk. Epiphany Prince. Jakobsen. Shot clock on four, got to go up and does so. And the rebound again. Well, not again, but he's Zelus rebounding this time. Badali calls the play. Oh, good defense. And the foul. That was terrific defense there from Eugenie Belukova. She didn't take the fake. He's prepared to drop on the loose ball. Here we go. There's the loose ball. And she drops on it and is fouled by Vidali. Giselle Vidali, Epiphany Prince now. Prince has had two jump shots from just inside the arc. And some of the zone, I think, from Fenerbahce. And this time, Prince goes inside, doesn't pull up for the jump shot, goes all the way to the hoop, and restores the lead for Dynamo Kursk. Zelus. Good denial defense from Osipova, but the lane opened up. Zelus saw it, didn't get the rebound. And the referees looking at each other and decide that it is possession Fenerbahce. Siobhan Zelus there, disappointed with herself. She did everything right except score the layup. Testing the rebound as well, and that came off the hand of Annette Jakobsen. All smiles here in the third and fourth playoff. Zelus to inbound. Vidali. Oh, great hesitation from Vidali. And the rebound. Wonderful rebound by Tucci Canizes. That's the fourth offensive rebound. Two from each team. For the coaches to point out, I think, in the locker room at half time. Prince pulls up from the arc this time, misses by a long way. And Osipova almost got another rebound. Well, we'll call it a loose ball, actually. Almost threw it onto the shins of Zelus. Charles inside. Well, not an awful lot Osipova could do about that. Once Prince gets it in the low post, she just takes that one-step move. Very powerful young lady, and Fenerbahce now with their biggest lead of the game. Simone Augustus has gone quiet since a dynamic start. Osipova inside, can't hang on to it, but she had a foot on the line. And back in for Dynamo Kursk, Nkadi Ogumiki. Much more confident play from Fenerbahce. Charles, nice pass. The open shot is missed, and the rebound Milovanovic. We're ticking down to the last 2 minutes of the first half. Augustus inside, and she misses and doesn't get the rebound. Here goes Zelus. Zelus inside into the corner. And the rebound, Augustus, and the foul, and it has been called unsportsmanlike. Well, it was very, very close to a breakaway foul. The referees are discussing it now. One official called an ordinary personal foul, and the other called an unsportsmanlike foul. Let's have a look. Now, there's the foul. The nearest official called personal. Coach Gundas Vetra wanted an unsportsmanlike foul. Eventually he got it, and Simone Augustus hits the first up two, and Dynamo Kursk will have possession. I think the interpretation there was that there was no attempt for the ball. It was very close to a breakaway foul. There were players just about ahead of the situation. So the interpretation, I suspect, is that there was not a legitimate attempt to get the ball. About 100 seconds remaining in the first half. Milovanovic, Vortu, and Dynamo Kursk regain the lead. Giselle Vidali, Demurin, Charles on the turnaround, and she's fouled again. Little touch on the elbow. Well, sometimes sometimes you have to wonder how a defensive player can touch the elbow of someone fading away there. But definitely a foul on Ogumiki. Slight shake of the head. Tina Charles ties things up. Again, she misses the second. The rebound, Ogumiki. 80 seconds remaining, first half. Prince pulls up for the jumper and buries it. Oh, that's her third attempt at a pull-up jump shot, and this time she is successful. Timeout, Fenerbahce. With Dinamo Kursk leading 28-22. Great form there from Epiphany Prince. Tina Charles, leading scorer for Fenerbahce on 8 points. Pamitra Hollingsworth, leading rebounder on 6. Simone Augustus for Dinamo Kursk. She's their leading scorer on 8 points. 6 of them very, very early in the game. This time, well, again, we're watching highlights of the first half. On that occasion, Epiphany Prince faked the pull-up for the jump shot and went all the way to the hoop. And here, an offensive rebound for Tiji Kanitez. Tina Charles there, a classic hoop shot. Milovanovic hits the three. Prince this time does pull up for the jump shot, and it was all string. Another lame attempt at defense there from Irina Osipova, and this time Milovanovic was inside the arc. Well, the timeout is over, 72 seconds remaining in the first half, and Fenerbahce to inbound. Vassell, Vidali, De Murmuren. Well, that's better boxing out from Dinamo Kursk. Last minute of the first half. Here's Epiphany Prince. Yelena Milovanovic. Shot clock single figures. That's a tough pass to make and a tough shot to make as well for Evkadi Ogumiki. Now Kursk lead by 4. Not their biggest lead. They have led by 7. Zalus, oh, good hands. Good hands from Belakova. And the shot and game clock not quite synchronized. There are 2 seconds separating them. Epiphany Prince. Now really, Dinamo Kursk should make sure they take the last shot here. Last shot of the first half. Prince, 3 seconds on the shot clock, and Prince misses. And the rebound is not secured by Ogumiki. There are 1.5 seconds remaining in the first half, and Dinamo Kursk leading by 4. And we have a timeout. Timeout, Dinamo Kursk. So, Evkadi Ogumiki has just taken over the mantle of leading scorer for Dinamo Kursk. She's on 9, Simone Augustus on 8. And coach Gundaz Vetra is just going to make sure that there's no foul in this last 1.5 seconds.
Bissell and Z. Z, you set a back for Bissell. Bissell, you run. This big, yeah, best the ball, just not there over. Best the ball to Z. Just, you know, try to shoot the ball. Let's go. 1, 2, 3.
Very clear and precise instructions there from Coach Rinucci. Ended with try and shoot the ball. It's going to be a long one. First of all, they have to get the ball in play. 1.6 seconds. It's going to be a long one. Zalouz, she took too long, really. Oh, it wasn't that far away. It's too late anyway. Dinamo Kursk lead Fenerbahce at half-time by 4 points in the third and fourth playoff of the Women's EuroLeague Final Four.
First half, score is 30-26 for Dinamo Kursk. Now we will have 15-minute break.
It's a lovely spring afternoon here in Prague. And we're almost at the end of the half-time interval of the third and fourth playoff in the Women's EuroLeague Final Four. It is Dinamo Kursk 30, Fenerbahce 26. Annette Jakobsen there, the Latvian player, 31 years of age now, coming towards the end of her career, but 2 points in that first half, and it was a lovely reverse layup as well, nice spin off the glass. Coach Jacek Winici, the 47-year-old Polish coach of Fenerbahce, saw his team recover from training by seven, to actually take the lead. The biggest lead was three, towards the end of that first half. They succumbed to a bit of a blast from Dinamo Kursk, and now Fenerbahce trail by four. But they do have the ball to begin the second half. Husel Badali at the point. Here is Siobhant Zalus. Into Tina Charles on the turnaround, in and out, and Simone Augustus rescues the ball. Tina Charles on 8 points, not quite the leading scorer in the game. That honour belongs to Mkadi Ogumiki on 9 for Dinamo Kursk. Here is Ogumiki inside and taking it to the hoop and pulling the foul against Tina Charles. Well, perhaps the Fenerbahce defense not awakened from their halftime slumbers, despite the smile from Tina Charles. Welcome to 13 points in the semi-final against Ekaterinburg, all 13 in the second half. First and the second take the lead back, not quite the biggest lead of the game, but it is a 6 point lead for Dinamo Kursk. Siobhant Zalus back to Husel Badali. Oh, good rebound, another offensive rebound for Fenerbahce, and it's Cicic Kanitez. Kanitez hits her fourth point, and I think that's her second offensive rebound as well. Irina Osipova. Ogumiki taking it to the hoop, and rather a forced shot, and a good rebound from Osipova. In and out, and eventually Tina Charles clears up. Bojovic inside, nice pass. Well, the shot was unsuccessful. Augustus, her shot was definitely successful. She moves on to 10 points. So two Americans leading the scorers for Dinamo Kursk. Well, the two of the Americans. Badali. The fadeaway shot again, patented almost by Tina Charles. Very, very, very difficult to do anything about, really. Simone Augustus to Wiki. Good Wiki. And the rebound, Osipova. This time, she decides to bring it out and regroup. A little step through. Wow, what great footwork from Irina Osipova. Some might call it cheeky. Great use of spin off the backboard as well from a very, very experienced Russian player. And no celebration. Well, the jump shot from Siobhant Zalus. Reduced the arrears back to four. This is where we were at half time with Kursk leading by four. Zalus now moves on to 9 points. Ogumiki with all the time in the world to find a pass. Augustus. Mickey from range, and the rebound, Osipova. At this stage in Osipova's career, that's what she's there for, to grab rebounds and loose balls. Go Justice to Osipova for the jumper. That's a very flat shot. And the rebound for Kenny Tez. And Tina Charles is fouled by Irina Osipova. That's Osipova's third.
She goes to the bench.
So Osipova hits the bench. Coming back in is Yelena Milovanovic. Tina Charles on the foul line. Charles normally a 79% foul shooter. She's taken a lot of foul shoots in the campaign. 34 from 43 before the semi-final and missing them both here early in the second half. Tiffany Prince. Augustus. Milovanovic, little fake. Into Ogumiki, who is fouled, and the foul is on the floor. Siobhan Salous looking around, saying, where was the help? Or would, was to that effect? Well, the help arrived, but somewhat late. Well, the foul as well. And on the foul line, Eugenia Belikova, who fails to complete the three-point play. Quick inbound there. And that's a six-point lead for Dinamo Kursk. Zalous into the corner. And that's good boxing out from Ogumiki. Miki taking it to the rack and scoring, such a powerful mover. And the lead now eight. This is the biggest lead of the game. Ogumiki hits a 13-point timeout, Fenerbahce. It's 40-32. Dinamo Kursk leading Fenerbahce in the third and fourth playoff game in the Women's EuroLeague Final Four. Kadi Ogumiki there, very, very close to a double-double. She's got 13 points and she's hauled down 9 rebounds. Tina Charles on the opposite bench, opposite team. Number 31, 10 points and 8 rebounds. There's Ogumiki. Hakan Fenerbahce do coming out of their timeouts. Still a long time to go in the third period. They come back from trailing by 7 in the first half, the lead by 3. Got to go back up that mountain. Zalous inside, pulls up with a jumper. And that is how to come out of a timeout. Very decisive play from Siobhan Salous. She's now on 9 points. Prince. And Ogumiki calls the play from the corner. And the rebound is Augustus. U14. Prince pulls up for the jumper inside the arc. And the rebound this time is Siobhan Salous. Milana Bojevic calls the play, number 25 for Fenerbahce, and inside to Juanitra Hollingsworth for her first score. That'll settle her down a great deal. No points, 6 rebounds in the first half. And she gets the first score of the game to take Fenerbahce within four. Milovanovic from the corner, and the three, Milovanovic! That's her 10th point. Oh, just as Fenerbahce thought they were back to within four, conceded a three. Bojovic. The foot violation by Milovanovic. It's one way of stopping the ball going inside. Yeah, didn't want Hollingsworth to receive that. Hollingsworth sets a back pick for Zalus. Well, that's a very tough shot for Zalus. And Milovanovic picks up the loose ball. Here's Belyakova. Milovanovic again. Not this time. And Hollingsworth the rebound. Bojovic. Siobhan Zalus inside. Tough defense from Augustus. And on the break, Augustus to Ogumiki. And at the moment, it's all Fenerbahce. Ogumiki now 15 points. The pass from Augustus. Biggest lead of the game. Remember, Fenerbahce have had a timeout a couple of minutes ago. Hollingsworth on the fade. Good hustle, but all to no avail. Substitution for both sides now. Belyakova comes out. And back in, Annette Jakobsen. Dinamo Kursk have a wealth of experience out there on the floor. Jakobsen into the corner for Milovanovic. Shokok on four and the steal. And this is Zalus on the break. Good hands from the Fenerbahce defense. And that is enough as far as coach Gündoğan Zvetra is concerned. He wants to talk things over. Well read by Siobhan Zalus. She couldn't get a clean steal, but she tipped it to a teammate and then finished off the break. Well, we're watching highlights of this third period. That was the end of a Dinamo Kursk fast break. Superbly finished off the pass from Augustus to Ogumiki.
Being ball to the side, Beef is here. Okay, so opposite from the ball player who you want to shoot. This one, do the cut quickly. This one, come here. Okay, so this one, come out here. Okay, so pass.
Gündoğan Zvetra. Holder of an unwanted record, has lost four semi-finals when the Women's EuroLeague has finished with a final four format. There he is. Will his day eventually come to be in the final? Well, definitely not this year. Coach Minichi there celebrating a superb steal and fast break for Fenerbahce, but the Turkish side still trail by seven. So just about 2.5 to go in the third, in this third and fourth playoff. Jakobsen, and well, Tina Charles had a man on her back there, and not a semblance of an offensive rebound from Dinamo Kursk. Vidali, Hollingsworth is living in that paint, and she was surrounded. Stephanie Prince. Prince can't get it into Ogumiki. Good passing, Jakobsen from the corner. And, well, Ogumiki couldn't get a hands on the rebound. Vidali. And the jump shot from Tina Charles. Tina Charles now moves on to 12 points. Fenerbahce refusing to lie down. Jakobsen has come on for her three-point threat. One suspects she's taken two and missed them both. Here she is again for another three-point attempt, and this time, no problem for the Latvian superstar. Bojovic ticking down to the last minute of the third. Charles defended by Milovanovic, and Charles on the turnaround again. Tina Charles, that deadly turnaround jumper. Charles moves on to 14 points. Prince Ogumiki, Jakobsen to Ogumiki, didn't expect it, but Jakobsen picks up the loose ball and then fires up the three. And again, superb boxing out. Now that's a great hustle from Ogumiki. She tapped the ball against an opponent's foot. Great awareness from a great player. 1 second on the shot clock. They hadn't regained possession. It needs a quick shot. Well, they've got to get the ball in first of all. Milovanovic. There's the shot clock buzzer. The ball actually was knocked out of bounds by Fenerbahce, but after the shot clock buzzer had gone. So there are 4.5 seconds between game and shot clock at the end of the third. The biggest lead of the game was 9. It is now 6 for the team on defense, Dinamo Kursk. Three-point shot is unsuccessful, and Jakobsen fouls Quarintra Hollingsworth. 7.5 seconds remaining in the third period. Good position there from Hollingsworth. Now, was it Prince or was it Jakobsen? Out of bounds, Fenerbahce. Here is Tina Charles. Jovic, Bojovic fires up for the three and misses. That should be it for the third period. Well, there are actually 0.7 seconds to go. It's going to be a long heave from someone, one suspects, Epiphany Prince. No. So 48 plays 42 after three periods of play in the third and fourth playoff of the Women's EuroLeague Final Four. There are the statistics of the three periods played so far, and you have to say neither team anything to write home about from three-point range. But there have been a lot of offensive rebounds taken and quite a few sort of 15 to 18 foot jumpers as well. And there's Tina Charles on the turnaround. Irene Osipova, look at that step through. Great awareness. Catching the defense napping there. Another turnaround from Charles. Ogumiki powering away to the hoop. Ogumiki on 15 points, 9 rebounds now. And Tina Charles, that turnaround again, 14 and 9. Plays 42 with Dinamo Kursk leading Fenerbahce with one period of play to go, unless of course we have that the dreaded overtime. Fenerbahce from Turkey, Dinamo Kursk from Russia. Kursk, the site of an epic battle years gone by, and they're in a battle now. Epiphany Prince running the show really for Dinamo Kursk. Just 4 points, 1 rebound, 2 assists, but it's her presence on court. Cool head, Epiphany Prince from Rutgers College in the United States. Well, just waiting for the clock to be reset at 10. We don't want it counting up, we want it counting down. And yet Jakobsen, 5 points, one rebound, one assist. Someone's got to get the instruction book out to see how to make it count down. Again, unsung heroes of basketball, the table officials. It is a very, very tough job indeed. Players have to have good reactions, and so do the table officials, I can tell you. The scorer, well, if you look down to register a score, you can have eyes in the back of your head, really, to look up. You may have missed a quick steal and a score. And here we go, it is the fourth period of the third and fourth playoff. And here is Jakobsen. Ogumiki sets a pick for a nice pass into Augustus. Augustus on the turnaround, hits the jumper. Simone Augustus, she hits 12 points now. A lead back to 8. Gonzalez. Charles inside to Juanitra Hollingsworth, cute to her friends. And she now is on 4 points. Very slow first half, but still a formidable presence on the floor. Cute Juanitra Hollingsworth. Oh, good hands from Vidali Vojovic. Trailing player is Tina Charles, and the foul, and the one. Well, of a sloppy period of play there from Kursk. They conceded the steal, and they may concede a three-point play. Jakobsen fouls, and Charles strong enough to score the two and get the bonus. Four fouls now. Jakobsen nods to coach Windows veteran to say, "I'll stay in there." And Tina Charles does complete the three-point play to become the game's leading scorer on 17. Prince, oh, lovely pass inside, and the foul, and the one. Well, Siobhan Salus fouled, and she's fouled Jelena Milovanovic. That was a scintillating pass. Well, I'm not sure that everyone in the crowd expected Milovanovic to receive that. The pass may have been meant for Ogumiki. Here is Milovanovic. Well, she fails to complete the three-point play, but her team Kursk lead by 5. Milovanovic now on 14 points. Dali. And the rebound chased down by Jakobsen. Prince. Jakobsen waiting patiently in the corner. And Prince inside gets a shot blocked. And on the floor for the first time tonight, OK Fakir, number 4 of Fenerbahce. As predicted, some inexperienced players getting some court time here, and a lovely baseline drive there from Siobhan Salus. And coach Minici still believes, and why not, with a three-point deficit now for Fenerbahce. Crowd building up here in Prague, and Augustus finds Jakobsen, quick pass into the corner, and the rebound by Hollingsworth. You can almost taste the tension here in Prague. Vidali against Prince. Tina Charles double teamed. And on the turnaround again, Tina Charles. We have a 1 point game. Tina Charles, it's her 19th point. Prince. Gustav pulls up for the jumper. In and out. And the rebound is Ogumiki. Ogumiki off the glass. Wow, what strength from Nkedi Ogumiki. It's back to a 3-point lead for Kursk. Ogumiki now 17 points. Nice fake from Zalus. And easy rebound. Vidali for three. It hits. It's tied at 54s. Oh, no one seemed to want the rebound there from Kursk. Prince to Milovanovic and the lead back with Kursk. Some tired legs out there. Both sides. Milovanovic has just hit her 14th point. Zalus. The three's up and in and out. And Prince the rebound. Now the band in the background going absolutely berserk. Everybody here in Prague enjoying this third and fourth playoff, and the foul. Trying to fight a way through it around the screen is OK Kakir. We have a cracker on our hands here in Prague, the third and fourth playoff, the women's EuroLeague Final Four. Exactly 6 minutes remaining. Prince. Wow, that's good offensive rebounding from Kursk. Team rebounding at that. Augustus pulls up for the jumper. And the rebound, Tina Charles. Game now boiling up to fever pitch. Dali to Zalus. Zalus into Charles. We're going to see another turnaround. Great passing from Fenerbahce. Zalus pulls up and shoots short. And Epiphany Prince doesn't touch the ball. She keeps her hand out of the cookie jar, so to speak. Coach Minichi there, the dry mouth, the cotton mouth of the coach in a tight situation. Epiphany Prince to Jakobsen. Augustus into the corner for Osipova. She's not going to shoot from there. Finds Jakobsen, Prince, shot clock six. Prince pulls up for the jumper, perhaps. No, it's Augustus for the three. And the rebound for Dali. Inside to Tina Charles. On the turnaround again. Well, Hollingsworth there. Bit of a wrestling match in there. Complaints to the officials. And then not one iota interested. Jakobsen. Milovanovic. Milovanovic pulls up for the jumper and misses. And the rebound is Hollingsworth. Vidali slows things down. The ball is in the hands of Shamont Zalus now. Four and a half to go, just under, in the fourth. Osipova just reaches and very nearly steals the ball. And Milovanovic takes a well-earned break. She goes out on 14 points and four rebounds. And back in comes Nkadi Ogumiki. Oh, nice pass into Hollingsworth. Misses off the glass. Here's Prince. Prince reminds her teammates what the play is. Augustus. Jakobsen for three. Hits the three. Jakobsen, that's her second three. She's got 8 points. Six of them from behind the arc. The lead back to five. Tina Charles. Box at her teammates. Zalus. Tina Charles again. That's good defense from Ogumiki. On the turnaround, Tina Charles again. Well, that must be five, six, perhaps seven turnaround jump shots that Tina Charles has made. And it's back to a 3-point lead for Kursk. Tina Charles is now on 21 points and 10 rebounds. Jakobsen. Oh, that's a very speculative pass. It didn't get there. But Dali waits for the trailing player. That trailing player is Tina Charles, who misses the layup. And Zalus angry. She was there for the rebound. Tina Charles put her head in her hands. How did she miss that layup with 3 minutes, 1 second remaining? Here's the layup. It missed. And that's a superb non-foul by Jakobsen. Remember, Jakobsen on four fouls. She didn't dare reach in there. And we have a timeout with Dinamo Kursk leading Fenerbahce by three with 3 minutes, 1 second on the clock. Coach Jacek, we need you there. Coach Fenerbahce. They trailed for most of the game. By eight in the first half, got it back to lead by three. They trailed by nine in the second half, and they are back to 3 points. Coach Gündoğ Zvetra there reminding his players, get back, get back, get back. They don't want to give up any easy layups like that one there from Siobhan Zalous. Tina Charles on the turnaround again and again and again. Milovanovic, Yelena Milovanovic. She's on the bench at the moment, but she's on 14 points. And Annette Jakobsen has hit two threes in her 8 point total. So Dinamo Kursk will restart with under three to go now in the fourth period. Seeming White's lead by three. Ogamiki inside again. A patented move, receives it on the high post and then lays it up. Ogamiki now moves on to 17 points. She's also pulled 11 rebounds. Zalous inside and the foul is Simone Augusta. She has fouled Juanitra Hollingsworth. Two fouls, Augustus, but only two team fouls against Dinamo Kursk. Two and a half to go in the fourth. Crowd here in Prague being richly entertained. No way in there. Here's Tina Charles, defended by Prince. Tina Charles on the running hook shot. It's back to a three-point game. Tina Charles now on 23 points. That was a classic mismatch there, Charles against Prince. Osipova, that's an offensive foul. She had a forearm in Tina Charles's throat almost. And the Fenerbahce fans, including the drummer, they still believe. Watch this foul from Osipova. That's right, the left elbow in the throat of Tina Charles. And Osipova comes out. Over two to go in the fourth period. Only 3 points separating these teams in the third and fourth playoff. Siobhan Zalous goes inside, lays it up and misses. And the rebound. It's Tina Charles, she's missed as well. And eventually the rebound for Ogumiki. Epiphany Prince. 100 seconds remaining in the fourth. Yelena Milovanovic. Simone Augustus, nice pass and the foul. Well, a pretty hard foul there, and Ogumiki, I hope she's not hurt her wrist. She's still smiling. She's always smiling. There's the foul, and that is a pretty uncompromising foul from Juanitra Hollingsworth. Thou shalt not score. I think that's what the referee's saying. That was a touch hard. Cue. No matter, it is two foul shots for Nemkadi Ogumiki. She hits the first for 18th point. A minute and a half to go in the fourth. Two from two. That's great poise for a player who's just been clattered to the floor. The lead five. Vandali, defended by Prince. Tina Charles. Not this time with a jump shot and the rebound and the foul. Hollingsworth has just fouled Ogumiki, going over the back. But Dali can't believe it. Let's have a look at the replay. Yeah, it's the principle of verticality that the referee was observing there, and Hollingsworth is definitely not going straight up. We have another timeout. And after the timeout is over, we will walk to the other end for two foul shots for Kadi Ogumiki.
Go under and try to bump big man. If it's a shot, everybody for rebound.
There's the foul trouble.
Offensively,
Zulus Hollingsworth.
If we got a stop, let's
and Charles on three fouls. And, Dinamo Kursk, Osipova and Jakobsen on four. Juliano Bojevic there signals the play. Siobhan Salus. Well, Osipova, I can't quite, don't think she quite believes that foul, but it was definitely an elbow in the throat. The referee took exception too. Coach Gundaz Vetra still urging his players on. 63 plays 58. In favour of Dinamo Kursk. Epiphany Prince scores the play. Well, we didn't have foul shots. That was indeed the fourth. So 70 seconds remaining in the fourth. Augustus into Ogumiki for no points. The rebound is Hollingsworth. Vidali. Last minute of the fourth period. Inside to Hollingsworth, who is fouled by Milovanovic. So that is the fourth. Both teams now in the penalty. Tina Charles to Zalus. Zalus going inside, pulling up for the jumper, and the rebound, if you can rebound an air ball, is Ogumiki. Ogumiki now on 19 points, 13 rebounds. And Prince tucks the ball under arm. They can run the clock now because Kursk lead by 5, 10 on the shot clock. Milovanovic pulls up for the jumper and hits. That's probably the killer. Yelena Milovanovic, 16 points now. And a killer jump shot. Vidali misses the three. The rebound is Milovanovic. And the long pass to Ogumiki for the two. That is it. Dinamo Kursk. Ogumiki is the 21st point. And the pass there from the magnificent Yelena Milovanovic. Zalus inside. And she steps on the end line. So it's a 9-point lead with 7 seconds to go. The lead for Dinamo Kursk. And there's that foot on the end line. Good defense there from Milovanovic. Get the wind knocked out of her somewhat, but it matters not one jot. The pained expression, but she'll be laughing when the final buzzer goes because Dinamo Kursk have won the third and fourth playoff against Fenerbahce by 9 points. A terrific game here in Prague. As the players celebrate, the players of Kursk anyway, and now exchange pleasantries with their vanquished opponents, Fenerbahce. So 67 plays 58. A wonderful exhibition of women's basketball. There's Tina Charles. What a game she had. 23 points and 10 rebounds, but she was on the losing side. And Kadi Ogumiki, leading scorer for Dinamo Kursk, 21 points and 14 rebounds. So consolation indeed for Dinamo Kursk. They lost in the semi-final against Ekaterinburg, but here they have won the third and fourth playoff by beating Fenerbahce 67-58. Připravujeme náš finálový zápas.
final for 2015. The medals for the fourth place team are presented by the board member of FIBA Europe, Mrs. Julia Anikeva, and the Secretary General of Czech Basketball Federation, Mr. Michal Konechny. Now please give a big round of applause for Team Fenerbahce. Here is the list of players on the fourth place of this tournament. Number 4, Oleksandr Sagir. Number 5, Agnieszka Dudzicka.
Well, the presentation for the third and fourth playoff teams. And it is Dynamo Kursk who will get, I suppose, what could be described as the bronze medals here. Fenerbahce now have to be content with fourth spots. A terrific third and fourth playoff. Dynamo Kursk won 67-58. It was tight right until the end. Fenerbahce, they kept fighting, kept coming back. But in the end, they just couldn't overcome a great team effort from their opponents. Hollingsworth there, just 4 points, but 11 rebounds. And Tina Charles, what a game she had. 23 points and 10 rebounds. Almost unstoppable with that turnaround jump shot. Siobhan Zalus there. 15 and 5, 15 points, 5 rebounds. And Milena Bojevic, 5 points. It was so close in the semi-final, but they eventually lost that to the home side, USK Prague, 49-62. Again, bit of a fourth period collapse for the team coached by Jacek Winiecki. A nice memento there for Vassell, Vidali, Demurimarin. Juanita Hollingsworth. She'll think about this long and hard. In fact, all the Fenerbahce players will.
The medals for the third place team are presented by the board member of FIBA Europe, Mrs. Carmen Tokala, and the vice president of Czech
Coach
Federation, Mrs.
Vetra. Content with winning the third and fourth place playoff games. Belikova, number 5, Irina Osipova.
Number 10, Epifanova Prince. Number 11, Maria Mesikova.
Simone Augustus, great game from her tonight. 14 and 7 and 4 assists. Irina Osipova. And some of the younger players didn't get on court tonight, but they'll be very happy with their third place medals. Epiphany Prince ran the show really for Dynamo Kursk at the point. Annette Jakobsen, crucial 2 3-pointers late in the game and leading scorer for the winners, Ogumiki. Nemkadi Ogumiki, 21 points and 14 rebounds.
And a member of the board of Czech Basketball Federation, Mr. Zdeněk Žiza. We'll now give the organizer's trophy to the captain of Dynamo Kursk, number 5, Evgenia Belyakova.
So with a reminder, that's the third and fourth player at the 2015 Women's EuroLeague Final Four. The third and fourth player has been won by Dynamo Kursk over Fenerbahce. The score is 67-58. Don't forget, on livebasketball.tv, you can see the Women's EuroLeague Final later on tonight. 6 p.m. in Central Europe, and it will be Ekaterinburg against USK Prague. What a game that promises to be. So for now, I'll see you in about an hour's time.
you one more time to the Fenerbahce. Ještě přichází čas na pozitivu Dynama Gursk. Dámy a pánové, jak už jsem informoval, bude třeba, abyste opustili halu, aby mohlo být vše připraveno následujícímu finálovému utkání, stejně tak, jako by bylo pátek. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank every one of you, but right now we need to leave the hall to get ready our hall for the final game. So, if it's not wrong for you, we would be really glad if you will leave the hall and stay just for half an hour. Then we are looking forward to see you back on the final game between UMS Yekaterinburg and ZSK Prague at 6 o'clock. Thank you very much one more time and congratulations for the both teams in our first year of Fenerbahce.